Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And again today I would like to show you something very interesting. Maybe that is what I think so. But let's take a look and see what I have made so far. So this is the third video about YoAnime, a PowerPoint add-in that I am creating to do more advanced shape and animation manipulation. And here you can see that I have applied two animation effects to the selected shape. Let me delete this one. And let's put it right here. So you can see the animation numbers here, number 1 and number 2, representing these two animation effects. So our animation manager is turned on along with our YoAnime server, and here we have the animation manager panel. This is just the beginning, and below this button we have web view 2 integration. So currently I have just initialized the web view 2, but we are not calling any methods from web view 2 to inside our PowerPoint slides. Currently we are using only WPF to apply the logics to the selected shape. So I have added a few more options to our spin animation, which I wrongly named as yo fly in animation. It should be yo spin animation. Anyway, so I set the duration, clockwise rotation, ease in, ease out, and style I would like to use cubic with auto reverse. And I would also like to add a delay between auto reverse. Don't want to add exponential factor right now, and would like to repeat this effect 5 times. So this option is not available in PowerPoint. You cannot add delay before the auto reverse. I will also add a delay between the repeats as well. So maybe 5 or 6 years ago I had created this file. Now 10 things that we want in next version of PowerPoint, but 30 things. So when I was creating education videos about PowerPoint animation, I had noted all these points down, which should be, these features should be available in PowerPoint. Anyway, so let's take a look at the animation and let's click the apply button. So as I have applied these two animation, you must take a great look at these two rectangles with number 1 and number 2. Whatever logic on this spin animation I have applied, that is the different thing, but see what it is going to do to these two rectangles representing the animation numbers. So let's click apply and see what happens. You can see the ease in movement here, and take a look at this. Have you seen that? It is playing with these rectangles like bat and ball. Very interesting. I don't know how it is doing that and what these two numbers represent actually in the object model, but it created a very interesting effect as well. So that is what I would like to show you, and you can see that we have almost crossed the barrier of PowerPoint object model and applied our own logics with new features that PowerPoint object model can understand through our com wrapper methods. However, my discussion with ChatGPT, he told me that you don't need to apply these so complicated logics to create your own custom animations. Instead, we can use storyboard, the WPF storyboard. And so after 2 days, I thought about that instead of using C# logic to animate each frame, we can use storyboards of WPF, which are more capable of doing the same thing with more ease. So I have not yet tried that, and we would also try to do the web view 2 integration with our shapes. I mean, I will try to manipulate the shapes and animations through HTML and CSS along with JavaScript. And my main goal is, as I had told you in my previous video, that I would love to embed the web contents as a com object into the PowerPoint slides. That is the main goal. However, the WPF storyboard animations are also going to do a great job to advance the animation effects in PowerPoint. So I hope you will like this video. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting. And you can also subscribe to our channel.